the president has made the decision not to release any of the photographs of the deceased Osama bin Laden. And rather than, I will give you the language the president used when he was recently interviewed about an hour ago to explain his decision. This is in an interview with CBS 60 Minutes, Steve Croft. The president was asked, he said that they were discussing when bin Laden's body was taken out of the compound. The president was asked about how they knew it was him. And he said, when they landed, we had very strong confirmation at that point that it was him. Photographs had been taken. Facial analysis indicated that, in fact, it was him. We hadn't yet done DNA testing, but at that point, we were 95% sure. Question, did you see the pictures? The president, yes. Question, what was your reaction when you saw them? The president, it was him. Question, why didn't you release them? The president, we discussed this internally. Keep in mind that we are absolutely certain that this was him. We've done DNA sampling and testing, and so there is no doubt that we killed Osama bin Laden. It is important for us to make sure that very graphic photos of somebody who was shot in the head are not floating around as an incitement to additional violence or as a propaganda tool. That's not who we are. We don't trot out this stuff as trophies. The fact of the matter is, this was somebody who was deserving of the justice that he received. And I think Americans and people around the world are glad that he is gone. But we don't need to spike the football. And I think that given the graphic nature of these photos, it would create some national security risk. And I've discussed this with Bob Gates and Hillary Clinton and my intelligence teams, and they all agree. Question. There are people in Pakistan, for example, who say, look, this is all a lie. Obama, this is another American trick. Osama is not dead. The president. The truth is that we were monitoring worldwide reaction. There is no doubt that that bin Laden is dead. Certainly, there is no doubt among al-Qaeda members that he is dead. And so we don't think that a photograph in and of itself is going to make any difference. There are going to be some folks who deny it. The fact of the matter is, you will not see bin Laden walking on this earth again. That's the conclusion of the excerpt, and I think states rather thoroughly why the president made the decision that he did. With that, I'll take your questions. Ben.
Thanks, Jay. Based on those comments, the president made a very compelling case why not to release the photos. So what was the internal debate, and was he ever seriously considering releasing photos?
Well, obviously the photos didn't exist until bin Laden was killed. So there's not a great deal of time between then and the decision. There are obviously arguments to be made on either side. The fact of the matter is, as the president described, these are graphic photographs of someone who was shot in the face, or the head, rather. And it is not in our national security interests to allow those images, as has been in the past, been the case, to become icons to rally opinion against the United States. The president's number one priority is the safety and security of American citizens at home and Americans abroad. There is no need to release these photographs to establish Osama bin Laden's identity, and he saw no other compelling reason to release them given the potential for national security risks and further, because he believes, as he said so clearly, this is not who we are.